bastard.
I knew you'd come to me. It's been 30 years. Did your life turn out to be the triumph you expected?
Why are you asking? You know damn well it hasn't. I still don't know what it is that makes us bastards. I thought I came close once.
Do you remember 1976, the long, hot summer?
Of course I do. I just got kicked out of school for organizing a ritual chant in assembly. Practicing black magic, the school said. You went berserk. And I just laughed. We seemed worlds apart.
I wanted a son that was normal, not one that was hell-bent on following the great family tradition with incense and weird music.
Well, we never saw eye to eye, did we? You with all your working-class pragmatism, and me, the arty-farty little shite. You knew how to hurt me, though, didn't you? Burning my books, for Christ's sake, that's what Nazis do. I never felt as angry as that before. After you fucked off down the club, I knelt down beside that pile of burning ash, and I felt something cold and evil squirming around inside me. I wanted revenge.
It happens to us all, since that bastard wanted more.
I always knew I wasn't the first Armstrong to do weird shit. So I did some searching around in the old family history books. Oh, and guess what I find? We had an ancestor who served with Cromwell, who became so rich and so powerful, even the king was scared shitless of him. And the history books tell us that he lived to see his 100th birthday. And then one day he was found dead in bed with three virgins, all with their throats cut, and the room awash with blood. The local church burned the body straight away and scattered the ashes into the sea. Did you know that, Dad? Or was that something else you just forgot to tell me?
What do you want from me? Guidance on how to mess up your life, or a history lesson on the curse that lies on us? Better to find out for yourself, don't you think? What right have you to sit in judgment over me? Or have you ended up with bloodless hands? Wasn't that you behind that fucking mess in London?
All right, I haven't. But a simple father-son conversation would have gone a long way, you know.
Oh, God knows I tried, but you were a right bastard, plain and simple.
I haven't come here to rake up the past. You said in your letter that I had to come here before it was too late, that you'd be gone from this world, and there was something I must know before you... You know, before you die.
You've probably guessed it by now from what you learned from the history books. It is all true. He did sell his soul. He wanted power and vitality. All the same shit that every... greedy bastard has wandered through time.
I know that much.
Well, he found a way of avoiding the collection of his soul. He sold his soul to another Archduke of Hell. When the crunch came and they both came to claim what they thought was theirs, they found they'd been duped. Suckered.
Ah.
So, they decided that rather than have a war in hell, they'd carry the curse on through the generations like a standing order. And would take the firstborn son.
Where did you learn all this? Oh, no. Now let me guess. On your father's deathbed. Well, how ironic.
You know, we haven't exactly had what you'd call a healthy father and son relationship, have we?
Oh, I can live with that. You lost your influence because I shut you out more and more firmly. What I couldn't live with was the constant disapproval, the mutual resentment. Oh, what a fucking mess.
It's too late for all that now. What you must do now, which is important.
You want me to stop that bastard's curse claiming your soul?
Because you've got to do that. So do you have any chance for you?
There's no fucking hope for any of us. Maybe I should just go now.
You've got to face the facts. You've got to save my soul if there's going to be any chance for yours. I will not see the morning light. And I need you to help me finish what started so long ago. I need you to take my body outside to your mother's grave and burn my remains before the blood has had a chance to cool in my veins. You'll find a can of petrol and wood enough for the job out there.
So what we have to do is try to buck fate. Right down to the last breath, we have to struggle all the way.
Maybe. That's all we've got.
Maybe it is. You're a bastard, all right, Dad. But if one bastard can't forgive another, who else will? It'll be over for you soon. I'll do what you ask. I suppose the least I can do is give you a proper funeral. Let you rest. Death is so undignified. We leave this world in just as helpless a state as we come into it. And now it's up to me to dispose of the evidence before the family guardian angels can come and collect. can join her now, Father. What was she like? What would she have thought of me? What's that? Going soft? Oh, no, Papa. No, not me. I just want to be able to sleep at night. Now and again.
Darling, I'm lost. Adrift in the dark. I'm clutching your words to my vampire heart once more. So let in the light. Turn me to don't end in bloodshed, dear. It's probably not love. Here we are in the darkest place. My reflection shows only